Anyway, but we're going to talk about chili right now. We're up in the kitchen, and boy, we got a whole bunch of too many cooks in the kitchen. Could be, first time. Tomorrow, we've been telling you all morning long, weather's going to be really nice for the third annual Simsbury Chamber Spooktacular Chili Challenge. It's at the Simsbury Meadows Performing Arts Center from noon to 5 o'clock. But we got the chili right here, and apparently got the music as well. Kind of threw me off a little bit. Why don't you say hi to Lisa Gray with the Chamber of Commerce. Nice to have you here.
Thank you.
And you brought an entourage with you.
Yes, we did.
Toby is with who?
Toby is with the residents at Brookside.
Put you on the spot with that.
He is in our amateur competition, although he is not an amateur. He is a professional.
We'll get to that in a second. And then you have Keith Dooley here, the executive chef at Plan B, and they're all over the place up in Simsbury. Nice to have you gentlemen here.
Thank you for having us.
So you brought a professional and an amateur. You also have a junior competition as well.
Yes, we do.
Yeah. So you're covering your bases, but sometimes I've learned in the chili cook-offs that I've judged, the amateurs are not only just as good as the professionals, they're better.
You bet. Yeah. A lot of times they are.
No pressure, Dooley, all right? Yeah. This is the third year you've done this, and it's grown quickly.
Yes, it has. Yes, we're expecting over 3,000 people this year, and thank you so much for the nice weather we're expecting tomorrow.
I accept tips. So, what's it take to be in this competition? I mean, how tough is it?
Well, it takes a lot of persistence. You've got to practice your recipe. Mm-hmm. You've got to be willing to come out there, particularly for the amateur chefs. It's not that easy because you have to cook everything on site, mm-hmm. according to health department rules.
Right.
So they bring everything and cook that day mm-hmm. on site, and they're cooking for 3,000 people, so that can be quite a challenge.
That's
they
a
have
lot
to
of beans.
Have
yeah.
enough chili to last throughout uh-huh. the day. Our event runs from 12 to 5.
Yeah, we're looking at pictures right now, people dressed up, and they. I see a lot of bags, your trick or treat bag. Do you just ladle the chili right in the bag, or are you looking
Absolutely.
For... Listen, if that's the way you want to do it in Simsbury...
Actually, everyone who arrives is given a tasting bag, and it has their little tasting cup and spoon, so that's what they'll find in the bag.
How does the health department feel about that, Lisa?
Yeah,
all right, never mind. All right, Keith, you've been a chef for how long?
I've been with Plan B for 2.5
now,
years.
They're known for burgers.
Yes.
Chili, okay, that's close. How do you up the ante every year and make the chili better and better?
We just try to use better ingredients, use fresh ingredients every time, not your run-of-the-mill chili powder and everything. Mm-hmm. Use good, wholesome chilies and nice cuts of meat. And
all right, to wit that we're not just some pretty talking faces here, ladle up what you got because I want to see how you've done this. And we brought two different styles, right? We also have a spaghetti Cincinnati style, which is what Toby's going to do.
Yes.
So you plate that up and you get to that. And while you're doing that, I'll get out of the way and we'll talk.
Sure.
Because we're the only two not cooking. So, third year in, 3,000 people. How do you keep tabs on judging all of this wonderful chili?
Actually, there's two different ways that we judge. Mm-hmm. The competition is actually sanctioned by the International Chili Society.
Which I love the fact that there is one.
Yes, not many people know that.
Yeah.
So most of the amateur cooks that are going to be with us tomorrow have been traveling all over the country all year mm-hmm. to compete in these chili competitions. Most of them actually just got back from the World Championships, which were held last weekend in Reno.
Right.
So this is going to be the first cook-off for the new chili year, and they're going to be competing to be able to attend the World Championships in October 2018.
Okay, fantastic.
So they are cooking traditional Texas red chili, which uh-huh. is just meat and sauce,
right.
chili verde, which is the green,
right.
and salsa. And those items are judged by a pre-selected panel of judges. Now, the people who come to attend the event mm-hmm. will also be able to taste what those cooks are going to be making that's called People's Choice Chili,
right.
which is what
which
we're going to
be
eating today.
Which is the award they really want,
yes,
right?
Yes, yeah. It's what you and I cook at home with the beans, and you might throw in corn, you might make it with chicken, mm-hmm. those types of things.
Toby did a Cincinnati style with
spaghetti.
It was spaghetti at the bottom, and if you've ever seen that, that's right over here. That's how they do it in Cincinnati. They serve it with spaghetti and onions and sauce. So I'm going to just take a little.
It might be a little challenge for you to eat.
Well, listen.
Gracefully.
I have. That's never stopped me before. Much of the chagrin of my bosses. So.
Good job.
There you go. Oh, that's good. Very nice. And okay, I'm going to, now, forgive me, I'm going to use the same fork, all right? But I'm just going to, right here on the edge, right here, so I can. We can still eat the rest.
So tickets are just $10 a person, and it includes all the chili you can handle.
Oh, that's good, too. Very nice.
And kids 10 and under are free.
That one's got a kick.
A little bit.
A little bit? No, that's not a little bit. Don't be modest here. All right. So if you want, tickets are still available, obviously.
Yes.
And it's what park again?
Simsbury Meadows Performing Arts Center. It's our wonderful outdoor concert venue we have right
now. And as we take a look at the forecast, weather's going to be just fine for the festival tomorrow. 62 degrees today, but 67 tomorrow, with temperatures going downhill as rain comes in late Sunday. And then cooler temperatures for Halloween. Halloween looks fine. 58 degrees. I eat the spicy stuff, and you've got the water over there.
You're welcome to taste my water.
I might have to. Thank you. Lisa Gray, thank you. Good continued success.
All right,
gentlemen, best of luck to you, and may the best bean win, okay?
You.
There you go.
Right.
That's it for now. We are going to say goodbye. Next broadcast at 4 o'clock. Thanks for joining us today.
All right.